This is Panama in Central America. Home of the famous Panama Canal. A shipping corridor which connects the Atlantic to the Pacific Ocean. And home to a small but growing Muslim community. Ray Henry works on the Panama Canal.
Transit, North 7, checking radio, good afternoon.
He is a member of the Muslim community here and has been chosen by that community to undertake the Hajj pilgrimage to Mecca. With great anticipation, Ray is now waiting for his visa to come through on time.
Estoy preocupada porque él tiene tanta ilusión con eso de hacer su peregrinación. Aunque él no la había planeado originalmente para hacerle de una vez, así, pero fue una sorpresa cuando le dieron que había sido escogido. Así que tenemos toda la ilusión de que sí va a ir, pues.
As you can see, my bags are out. Ready.
Ya empezó a medirse cómo se tiene que poner el... es como una tela dándose la vuelta acá.
That was one important one. Big enough. I told me normal toes, the normal toes wasn't gonna work. And I am not that big a person anymore. I'm shrimp of what I used to be. But I'm too short.
Mandó a comprar una carterita para la cintura para poner los documentos ahí.
Everything was thought about. Pouch for my belongings, which also serves as a belt. So, chance of her falling off would have been very, very slight.
La junta directiva eligió al señor Ray Henry para ser el postulado de parte del Centro Cultural Islámico a la peregrinación en este año. Porque cumple ciertos requisitos que la junta directiva se fija en ellos.
My name is Ray Henry. I'm a native of Panama. Most importantly, I'm a Muslim. Goodbye. Marhaban. Hello. Kalbu Sahirun. Small dog. Ahmaru. Yellow. Ahmaru. Red. I got it wrong. Well, I started taking informal classes about a year ago. But the teacher left for the Middle East, and I've been trying to do it on my own. And I got this book and been practicing, but like I say, the books and conversation are so much different, and you have to tune your ears in. A lot of times words sound alike and they're not. And I don't really have anybody to practice with except a computer.
Are you a doctor?
Nah. Here we are in 7th Street, Central Colón, city I grew up in. Well, partly grew up in. Colón is one of the second most, it is the second most important city in Panama, the Atlantic terminal of the canal, and as such, enjoys a very privileged situation. Most perfectly designed city in the world. Basically a square, 16 streets and avenues, and it's almost impossible to get lost.
Oh, man, look at that guy. Look at that. Oh, my God. Oh, my God. idea of Islam did appeal at some point, but it was tainted by overtures of racism from the current that I received, and a lot of negative media input. But I did get started reading pamphlets on the life of the Prophet, peace and blessings be on him, and seeing how much an extraordinary person he was. And I guess about 4 years ago, in a lodge meeting with a Muslim brother, and I started asking Muslims about the religion. And I came to understand the true meaning of Islam. And I think about 3 months after that, I took Shahada.
Históricamente, en Panamá nunca se ha querido hacer una historia de los musulmanes en esta área. ¿Por qué? Porque Panamá era parte de la colonia española. Y si nosotros nos remontamos al periodo de la Inquisición, cuando mataron a los musulmanes y los obligaron a cambiar sus nombres, el Islam en esta parte del mundo, en la América Latina, era un tabú. Pero históricamente, los primeros musulmanes que llegaron aquí en Panamá vinieron del África.
Si es de origen árabe, es la que habita prácticamente en Colón. Y hay en las provincias del interior, hay mezcla de gente que son, al fin y al cabo, son musulmanes, no se fijan.
Y en los 50 comenzaron a traer mujeres de sus lugares para casarse. En los años 70 había un grupo de panameños, ¿no?, que fueron influenciados por Elijah Muhammad en los Estados Unidos, ¿no?, el movimiento negro de los Estados Unidos y los musulmanes negros de Estados Unidos, en la cual Malcolm X era parte, ¿no? La primera mezquita que se construyó en América Central fue construida aquí en Panamá y fue inaugurado en enero de 1982. Y de allá a ahora tenemos 10 mezquitas en la República de Panamá. Panamá tiene 9 provincias, pero tiene 10 mezquitas.
Cuando él abrazó el Islam me sentía un poquito como incómoda, porque yo lo veía y decía, pero ¿cómo de repente ahora él se va a volver religioso? Y entonces se vuelve religioso y es más religioso que yo misma y hace cosas que me inquietaban, pues me preocupaban, porque nunca se había comportado de esa manera. Él tuvo un cambio tan grande en su conducta que yo lo observaba y me quedaba mirando, ¿será verdad o me estará echando un cuento? ¿O es verdad que cambió? Pero oh, qué bien, el cambio ha sido increíble y ha sido un giro completo que dio.
Él es uno de los que yo veo que por su sinceridad, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala le va a dar todas las directrices que él quiere para que él pueda ser una de las personas que entre en el paraíso en el día del juicio. Y si es para él ir a Meca, él irá a Meca y él encontrará en la ciudad de Meca, la casa de Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, una paz y una espiritualidad que nunca lo encontraría en ninguna otra parte del mundo.
I don't get excited. I don't really get excited when I see the Prophet. I yearn to go there, but I find myself getting a little more emotional now that I'm older. I never cried. I wasn't the type of a person who cried, but you know, silliness had me welling up with tears. Go to the movies and certain scenes get you. That's age. That's the age of process. But God willing, I'll be here, right here. Inshallah.
keep locking up this place like you're in jail. Keep locking up the place like you're in jail.
Everything is in God's hand, not in man's. And it's something that he apparently would like to, because he's the type of person, you know, from he was small, he was that kind of person that always is always inquisitive about things. He never accepts what we tell him, because he has a final, he's always asking why, and you know. Listen, I tell you about your tongue. It is a dangerous tool. Be careful of what you say.
You don't understand.
Okay.
You
plan to go and stay? No. Again, I tell you, that depends on the Lord.
You just said no one knows the time, the place.
Oh, okay.
But then you make
so match. What you said you mean?
That's why I make sure.
Why should you be negative?
I'm not being negative.
You have to be positive in everything you do.
What's negative about that?
You listen to your, you know English, right? You listen to your statement?
Yes, okay. Ma'am. I might not come back.
Okay.
But that's not, there's not negative about that. It's just a transitory statement.
Well, I put everything in the Lord's hand.
Yeah.
And there's nothing else I can do but just pray, right?
Can you leave the camera here? It does great things with my mom's memory.
السلام عليكم. الأخ محمد كيف الحال؟ جمال صخر بنما. ¿Cómo estamos? ¿Todo bien? Todo un momento. Cuéntame, hermano, ¿qué ha habido de nuestra visa del hermano Rey?
First we're going to Balboa, so I can get some cash for my trip. Then I go pick up my license plate. And we'll go meet Dr. Abdul Kabir somewhere in Panama. I have to call him to find out where that will be. Panama City to Colón and vice versa. In our case, from Colón to Panama City. I won't be able to get married. Gracias. But you know you have a hearing problem, especially when it comes to talking to me. So.
I found the compatibility with my faith and the way I should live. It became clear to me that man's laws could never supersede the laws that God Almighty has sent to us.
It's 12:30, time for Dhuhr. So I came to the masjid here in Mexico to perform, to make salah.
As we know, inshallah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give you the opportunity to visit his house, visit the place that was built by Abraham for the worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Among that, you'll meet many Muslims from all over the world. And people are going to be surprised to know that there are Muslims in Panama, because people don't know Panama. Panama to people is the United States, because the United States at one time had control of the Panama Canal. So when you say Panama, they say, oh, you're state of the United States. It's, you know, you have to explain to the people, no, you don't. But one of the most important thing that I can say to you and anybody that's planning to make Hajj is that go there with your heart hoping to accept the message from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
Antes de ir al Hajj, aprenderse estas palabras. La beika la umma la beika.
Dr. Abdul Kabir Muhammad, I met him at the masjid months after I'd taken Shahada. I didn't know who he was. I saw this elegant gentleman walk in, and everybody flocked around him. And I found out that his name was Abdul Kabir. And subsequently, I met him. I seek counseling from Abdul Kabir. I can call him concerning any subject. And if he does not have a ready answer, I'll get back to you and look it up. For the last 2.5 years, he has tried to be here every weekend to dictate classes, especially to Panamanian converts.
El primero y tú comienzas a tirar las piedras, ¿no? Ahí tú vas a ver a la persona con tanto entusiasmo, tiran hasta chancleta y tiran de todo. Una cosa importante, antes de salir el Hajj, la persona debe hacer un testamento, porque uno no sabe si va a regresar.
Es un viaje difícil y no es un área donde va, no es cómodo, porque te vas a mezclar con miles, con millones de personas y área que es muy caliente. No está asignada o no está diseñada para el turismo o para descansar. Obra del Todopoderoso, porque si estás haciendo el peregrinaje es para Dios.
Y todos están haciendo lo mismo, todos están vestidos igual. Tú no sabes quién es rico ni quién es pobre. En ese momento también la gente vive con una armonía, con un amor que tú sientes realmente.
Yeah, I've just gotten emotional because of this. Every Muslim who gets this call must answer to it. You just have to go.
Y de hecho, el hermano Rey, si le llega la visa y puede cumplir con su sueño, porque es sueño de cualquier creyente, porque es un deber y es un pilar de la fe islámica o un pilar del Islam, aquella persona que tiene la condición física y monetaria de hacerlo, lo debe hacer.
Bueno, ahora sí ya estamos listos para la cena.
Bueno, aquí en Panamá la visa la tenemos que mandar a Caracas. Por lo regular, otros países lo emiten igual como México. A Panamá le toca Caracas y tuvimos esta vez un poquito de retraso en cuanto a la emisión de la emisión de las visas en Caracas. Primero, que todavía no tenían la orden de emisión.
Rey está nervioso. Rey está muy, muy, muy nervioso. Time is going short. I've heard from
Ahora
Lee,
que él vaya.
From Jamal. I'm praying that by the time I get to
la tapa de estomaica para que no se
the masjid for Isha. Somebody has good news for me. The original plan was for me to leave my original plan was to leave on the 4th. And Jamal says, hey, that's gotten it too close. Any setback, and you won't make it. And we're not sure when the moon will be sighted to start Dhul Hijjah. So he had suggested leaving the 1st, and I tried to leave on the 29th. I have a reservation for the 30th also, but like I said, it's looking kind of tight.
Claro, claro. No, sí, estamos de acuerdo. Pero ¿tú crees hasta qué fecha él cree que todavía hay posibilidad? No, yo entiendo eso. Yo entiendo eso al 100%, arquitecto. Tranquilo. Listo, man. Cómo no, estamos en contacto. Todavía no. todavía hay una pequeña posibilidad de conseguirle el cupo y prepararle el viaje, etc. Pero le veo un poco difícil y muy cerrado. El calendario ya no da, no se estira más, no se puede más.
Ambassador and somebody else in Venezuela, and about 30 of us were in the same predicament. And at this stage, I'm sure I'm very disappointed.
Don't worry, I won't cry.
And you say there's a chance for Monday, or there's.
Just being realistic, even if it comes through on Monday. The flight is at 8:30 in the morning, and the offices are closed. They close tomorrow. So keep my intention to make Hajj next year, inshallah. This means I have to work a little harder. Like I said, I understand it is Allah's will, and I don't question that.